church. Every week after a choir sings or the quartet sings or there's a solo, almost always you will hear me offer up a word of gratitude. That's not because I feel obligated to do it. It's because I genuinely feel it. Because we are so grateful. You know, a couple of weeks ago during the pulpit exchange, Brian Evans, the senior minister from First Lutheran, was preaching here. And when I got together with him to ask him about our mutual experiences in preaching each other's pulpits, the first thing he said was, "Your choir is phenomenal." And I couldn't agree more. We have the best, I believe, musical program in the city. And I, for one, have become very spoiled because of it. I'm sure that you have as well. Jeanette, I've asked you to say a few words of appreciation.
Yes. So, hope you don't mind, I just wanted to take a minute and say, before I came to Smithfield, for most of my life, I was raised a Roman Catholic. So I went to church, Roman Catholic, all the time. One of the things I noticed was, they never sing all the verses. I don't know if many of you have been to a Roman Catholic. Like, there's four, they might sing two. There's five, maybe three. Never more than three. And I always thought, is the music just not important to them? And I remember vividly the first time I came to this church, and they sing every verse. And the music was just as important as everything else. And that's one of the things that really pulled me into this church. So, and I think, as Doug said, our choir is the best. So on behalf of the congregation, I want to say to all of you, Jim, to all of you, thank you so much for everything that you do.
Stand up, Barb, would you stand up too, please? We've already applauded for you, but one more time.